Yes.
We ordered some pizza for everybody to take with them. It'll be in a few minutes. While we're waiting, if you would lend us your attention just for a few more minutes to pass out some more information to you. If you did not receive the sheet that's titled Angels Dealing with Sorrow, raise your hand. Get a couple people.
I'm going to have Rochelle come
and present us briefly with the seven stages of grief. And by that time, she finishes the we don't want you to leave without taking something with you, man.
Amen. I want to do one more thing. Can everybody gather around the parents so we can pray, the family so we can pray?
Amen. I'll ask Byron and Brian and the family to come to the front. The reason that we invite worshipers and those who are desirous of prayer to the altar is because the reason that this part of the sanctuary is called the altar is because it comes from the word alteration. Alteration. It is that the altar where whatever needs fixing can be fixed. Amen.
Amen.
So coming to the altar, we do so because the word altar implies alteration, or to make adjustments, to fix, or to make whole. For those who feel, well, we've done this before, we can never get too much prayer. Jesus says that man ought always pray and not faint. The Apostle Paul paraphrased the saying of Jesus by saying that we should pray without ceasing.
Amen.
And our prayers, as has been mentioned, earlier by LJ, is our dialogue, our communicating with God and listening while he communicates with us, talks back to us. Father, we give you glory, we give you praise, we give you honor, even now, for what you have already done and what you are doing in the midst of what appears to be total chaos. We thank you that the rumbling of the thunder, the flashing of the lightning, and the billows that are rolling are all signs of your wondrous works and your magnificent power that symbolizes the fact that you are still in control. Because every storm is just your power being displayed. The storm cannot rage unless you give it permission to. the lightning cannot flash unless at the stroke of your hand. The thunder cannot roll if you do not exercise your power. Satan cannot harm us. He cannot defeat us. He can't test us unless you give him permission. Which says to us that you're still omnipotent. You're still all powerful. You're still omniscient. You still know everything. And we thank you that even now, you know the end results of our tests and our trials. Father, we admit that we're human. And we don't have to tell you because you made us, you created us. We admit that we hurt, that we grieve, and yet even now we're still in the early stages of trying to cope with and trying to figure out and understand why you permit certain things. But beyond that, God, we thank you for the comfort of your spirit and of your word. We thank you for the comfort, God, of your angels. We thank you, God, that not one iota of your word, not one dot or tittle is going to fail. We thank you, God, that even in this hour, in this moment, we are lifting Byron and Javonia and Rudel and TJ and the entire family before you, even the Macedonia family, all of the cousins and all other relatives and friends and acquaintances. We're lifting them before you now because we are all dealing in our own way. We know how this, what has transpired, but we thank you that you sent your word to heal us. We thank you, God, now for the counselors and all of the presentations that have been going forth tonight. We thank you, God, how you undergirding. We thank you now, God, how that you have broken chains and that you have set captives free. We thank you even now, God, how you have released your power and through forgiveness, you're healing even now. We thank you, God, for the maturity in Javonia and Byron as they are reaching out even to the offender to say, I forgive you and I love you. And because of taking that major step, God, even right now, at this altar, we'll be an altar. Thank you for making the adjustments in our lives. Thank you for the testimony that follows this experience. Thank you for the ministry being empowered to do what you have designated to the church to do, what you have commanded the church to do. Your word in Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has sent me to preach the gospel, good tidings to the meek or the poor. He has sent me to bind up the broken heart, to proclaim liberty to those that are bound, and even to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. We thank you for that same spirit right now, that anointing, for touching these minds of the adults and the children as well. Now, we plead the blood of Jesus over each individual that Satan cannot come now to dwell. We thank you for opening doors in the natural and the spiritual that needs to be opened. And we apply the blood of Jesus over those doorways that the enemy cannot enter. And we thank you for shutting doors that need to be shut in the natural and the spirit realm. And we apply the blood of Jesus over those doorways that the enemy cannot enter. We're always asking you to open doors, but sometimes some doors need to be shut. And we thank you for shutting those doors. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you for hearing. Thank you for answering. And for granting unto us our petition and your peace. And the people of God said, amen.
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 And amen. Fellowship, love somebody if you return to our seats briefly. In Jesus' name.
Oh, Lord. Yes.
If you would hold your positions for just a moment, Ms. Johnson has a presentation, and